gonna have fun, Slammy. Oh, look who's here, Slammy. Listen, I don't have time to tell you to scram. I promised Slimy I'd take him to the mud hole.
Oh, yay!
Oh, you know what? You're gonna need your hiking boot, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'll be right back, Slimy. Stay here.
The big bad wolf!
Puff and puff! Oh, where did those three little pigs go? A worm! I've never huffed and puffed a worm before. Huff and puff!
Slimy! Hey, did you see that bird? Slimy just flew into my bowl of spaghetti.
Oh, don't be silly, Snuff. Worms don't fly. Slimy, what are you doing in Snuffy's bowl?
It's okay, Slimy. You can tell us.
I don't know.
You don't want to tell us? Maybe the wind blew him all the way over here.
I don't feel any wind, bird. Not even a little breeze.
Well, maybe it's windier over by Oscar's trash can. Did the wind blow you over here, Slimy?
Yeah, it blew over here.
I knew it.
So smart, bird. It's okay, Slimy. I'll give you a ride back.
No.
Oh, it's all right, Slimy. Don't worry about it. Just hop on my snuffle here.
Okay, I got your little hiking boots, Slimy. Slimy, where'd he go? Hey, have you seen Slimy?
There you go, Slimy.
Oh. Hey, what's the big idea run off with my worm?
We didn't run off with him, Oscar.
Yeah. The wind blew him way over there.
I didn't feel any wind. Well, never mind. We gotta get to the mud hole. I got your boot, Slimy. Hey, you're shaking. What, are you cold? I better get you your sweater. Yeah.
Bye-bye, Slimy. See you later.
Bye, Slimy. Have fun.
He's gonna get a sweater.
Oh, Piggy! Oh, look, the one little worm. Well, since I can't see the three little pigs, I guess I'll just have to huff and puff the one little worm again. Huff and puff!
Here's some more spaghetti.
No, the spaghetti's for me, Alan.
I know, but Slimy just flew into the bowl.
No, Alan. Worms can't fly. It was the wind.
Yeah, because Slimy keeps getting blown all the way over here from Oscar's trash can.
Yeah.
The wind blew you over here?
Yeah, a wind.
But it's not windy at all today. Slimy, is that what really happened? You sure?
Yeah!
It's the big bad wolf!
Puff and puff!
Hey, Slimy, you're shaking.
Hey, where's that sweater that Oscar was getting for you?
You know, I think I know what's going on here. Slimy, now if somebody's bothering you, you need to tell a grown-up that you trust. Do you trust me to help you, Slimy?
Yes.
Tell me then, is it the big bad wolf?
Yes.
The big bad wolf?
The big bad wolf's been huffing and puffing you, hasn't he?
Oh, yes.
Oh, Slimy. Why didn't you tell us you were being huffed and puffed?
I'm scared.
Oh, you were scared.
Well, I'm really glad you told us, Slimy. Now you don't have to handle this alone.
Yeah, Alan won't let the big bad wolf huff and puff you. Right, Alan?
Of course I won't.
And we won't let him huff and puff you either, will we, Bird?
No. Friends don't let friends get huffed and puffed.
And I'll puff, and I'll forget about it. I'm winded. I know. I'll just huff and puff that one little worm. Wormy, where are you?
Elmo.
Ah, there you are.
No, you don't. You can't huff and puff Slimy.
Sure I can. It's easy.
Well, of course it's easy. You're big and he's little.
Yeah.
Yeah. Stop huffing and puffing, my little friend.
Okay, I'll just huff and puff you, you big galoot. No. Huff and puff!
Snuffy, look what you've done. Snuffy!
Oh, Wormy.
Don't even think about it. Come on, Slimy.
Snuffy, are you okay?
Yes, Bird. Just a little bruise on my snuffle.
All right, here, let's help you up, okay?
Thanks. Oh, thank you.
I thought I told you to scram. Hey, don't tell me. The wind blew you all the way over here to my trash can, right?
It was the big bad wolf, Oscar.
The big bad wolf?
Yeah, he's been huffing and puffing Slimy as well.
You okay, Slimy? Huh. No one huffs and puffs my worm and gets away with it.
Now, Oscar, calm down. We can talk to him. Look, here he comes now.
Did you see that? I just huffed and puffed a snuffleupagus. Best huff and puff ever.
Excuse me.
Hmm?
Mr. Wolf?
Oh, please. Call me Big Bad.
Big Bad, you just can't go around huffing and puffing people.
Or snuffleupaguses.
Yeah.
Or worms.
Oh, sure I can. I mean, I'm the big bad wolf. Huffing and puffing is what I do. It's part of my story. It's my raison d'etre. Just ask the three little pigs. Now, some wolves like to hunt and howl, but for me, that's not enough. I'm the kind of big bad wolf who likes to huff and puff. I huff and I puff and I can't get enough. I huff and I puff, yes I do. I huff and I puff all kinds of stuff. I might even huff and puff you.
He might even huff and puff you, hoo-hoo.
My lungs are as large as a dragon's. My breath is as strong as a gale. I'm the windiest wolf in the forest, and that's why I love to exhale. I huff and I puff, it's really not tough to huff and to puff night and day. I huff and I puff, I'm not one to bluff. My puffing will blow you away.
His puffing will blow you away.
I don't care much about growling. I never could wolf down a meal. But puffing's a breath of fresh air. You can understand the appeal. I huff and I puff, I would say off the cuff. I respire with gusto and flair. I huff and I puff and I huff until what is here's over there.
Until what was here's over there.
I huff and I puff, I can't get enough. I huff and I puff, yes I do. I huff and I puff. So you see, huffing and puffing is what I do.
Well, how would you like it if somebody huffed and puffed you?
Oh, I wouldn't mind. Go on, huff and puff me.
No, we are not gonna huff and puff you.
No way.
How about you, one little worm? Go on, Huffing and puffing's fun.
Fun? You call scaring a little worm fun?
What?
And hurting a snuffleupagus?
Yeah.
Who did that?
You did!
Me?
Yeah, with all of your huffing and puffing.
I had no idea. I'm sorry, one little worm. I didn't mean to scare you. And I'm sorry to you, you big galoot. I didn't mean to hurt you. I guess I was just caught up in the huff and puff moment.
Well, it happens to everyone, I guess.
Well, I am just glad you understand how bad it feels to get huff and puffed.
I do. I'm a very empathetic wolf, you know. I promise you, the huffing and puffing stops right here, right now.
Good!
Way to go, big bad!
Only
what?
It's just that huffing and puffing is what I do. It's my life.
Well, we just need to find something else for you to huff and puff where no one gets hurt.
Yeah, something besides worms.
Or snuffleupaguses.
What else is there?
Hey, we're taking a story break. Anyone want to blow some bubbles?
Bubbles! Bubbles, that's a great idea. You can huff and puff bubbles.
Yeah, bubbles won't hurt anybody.
As long as you think it's a good idea, let's blow some bubbles.
All right.
Yay!
Huff and puff!
Wow!
Just call me the big bad bubble blower. Anyway, what's that? Just, you've got it, my one little worm. More bubbles coming right up.
Okay.
Hello, I'm Mark.
And I'm Murray.
And we're here to tell you about the word empathy.
Empathy, yes, empathy.
Tell them about the word empathy. What's wrong?
You're not gonna believe this, Mark.
What?
But I can't remember what empathy means.
No, that's okay. That's okay. I'll tell him what empathy means.
Oh, boy! This is so exciting! Mark Ruffalo is gonna tell us about empathy! Oh, boy! Oh, boy! Oh, boy! Oh, boy!
Can I do it?
Go, please. Go for it, Mark.
All right. Empathy is when you're able to understand and care about how someone else is feeling.
Oh, right! That's what empathy is!
Yes!
I don't get it.
What?
Sorry.
Okay, let me see if I can explain it to you in some way.
Okay, I'm gonna listen.
Let's say I'm walking along and...
What?
I stubbed my toe. Oh, that hurts.
Oh, you poor thing,
Murray.
Mark. Oh,
Murray.
That hurts. I can imagine exactly how you feel.
That's
Ouch. Why? What's it?
That's it. That's empathy.
What's empathy?
You could imagine exactly how I feel. You could understand just how it felt. That's empathy.
I still don't get it.
What?
I still don't get it.
Okay. Let's think of another way.
Okay, let's think of another way. Thinking.
Oh. Murray.
What?
Did I tell you about that time when I lost my favorite teddy bear?
Oh, no.
It was...
This is very sad. Did you love that teddy bear?
I loved that teddy bear.
Oh, I can imagine exactly how you feel. It's really sad feeling. It makes me want to cry like this.
It was sad. It was so sad. But you know what?
What?
You know what empathy is.
I do?
That was empathy.
What?
You could understand how I was feeling, exactly how I was feeling, and understood it. That's empathy.
I get it now. Yes! Yes, I get it!
Yes!
I understand empathy!
You understand empathy, Murray.
I'm so happy right now.
I'm happy, too.
It makes me want to dance the dance of happiness.
I can imagine exactly how you feel. What? I want to dance the dance of happiness, too.
Then what are we waiting for?
Let's do it!
Oh, hi! I'm just pretending my arms are wings because in a little while, we're going to Abby's Flying Fairy School! I can't wait! But first, we're gonna talk about... the letter T! That's why we're gonna play... What's on Me? That starts... starts with T.
What sound does the letter T make? Can you find anything on me that starts with the letter T?
Your T-shirt?
That's right, T-shirt.
A tie?
Yes,
tie. Tiara?
Yes,
tiara.
I love this game. Now let's check out more about the letter T.
T will take us to a word that starts with the sound. Tiger. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh, hey, letter T, come back. Now sing with Cookie Monster. Aha!
Letter B day. So show me what you brought that starts with the letter B.
Banana.
Oop, oop, oop. Belly button bologna.
Bunny.
Beautiful B words! Bravo!
Ah, that bunny just bopped Mrs. Sparkle Nose on the head!
Bop, 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 bop.
At least bop is a B word.
Whoa! What kind of bunny is this?
Let me check my big book of bopping beasts.
Uh-oh. That's no ordinary bunny. That's...
Little Bunny Foo-Foo!
Huh?
Oh, you've never heard of the infamous Bunny Foo-Foo? His story goes like this.
Little Bunny Foo-Foo, hopping through the forest, scooping up the field mice and bopping them on the head. Down came the good fairy, and she said,
Little Bunny Foo-Foo, I don't want to see you scooping up the field mice and bopping them on the head. I'll give you 3 more chances, otherwise I'll turn you into a goon.
And what happened?
He kept bopping and bopping until finally the good fairy came and turned Bunny Foo-Foo into a goon.
Why isn't he a goon anymore?
Goon spells don't last forever. You have to do them a goon and a goon. I mean again and again.
Oh, come on! Let's stop this bunny's bopping and turn him into a goon!
I don't know if we should.
Keep your wings calm, Donnegan.
I'm trying!
gone again.
He's gone again.
Well, we can't wait. We have to turn this bunny into a goon. We need your help. Use your wand or your finger. Point it at Bunny Fufu and say, "You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon.
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon. You're a goon."
Oh, no. What happened to Gone Again?
He's goon again.
I'm a goon?
Looks like we gooned the wrong guy.
Don't worry. I just need to degoonify him. Goon, be gone.
That Fufu sure is fast.
We can't get the spell out in time.
Maybe we just need to put something on our head that will keep Fufu there long enough to do the spell.
Great thinking, Gonagin. But remember, today is Bee Day, so it has to be something that starts with the letter B.
Let's twinkle think. What's something that starts with B that'll keep a bunny on your head?
Twinkle think, twinkle think, twinkle think.
A beret?
Nah, won't hold him. A book?
Nah, we don't even know if he can read.
I know! Bubblegum!
No! Don't you know you're never supposed to put bubblegum in your hair?
Yeah, you're overthinking it. It starts with a B, and it's sticky. Ow! Here, Fufu! I got a nice head for you to bop! It worked! Hurry! Do the spell!
Wands up, everyone!
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon! Goon!
Oh, no! Am I a goon?
Hard to tell.
Okay. Goon be gone!
Ah, there's that handsome face I know and love.
Okay, so the bubble gum didn't hold Fufu long enough, and it messed up your hair. We better think some more.
What can keep a bunny on your head long enough to do the spell?
Let's twinkle think.
Twinkle think, twinkle think, twinkle think.
Ooh! When you eat, you stay in one place. So, what kind of food does a bunny eat?
Carrots!
Then maybe we could put a carrot on our heads. And then Fufu will stop and eat the carrot and give us enough time to do the spell.
Great idea! Here you go, Bunny Fufu. Hurry, do the spell.
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon!
I'm a goon. Goon, be gone.
Aw, how come the carrot didn't work? Bunnies love carrots.
Because Bunny Fufu knows it's a bee day. You need some vegetables that begin with B.
We better think of vegetables that begin with B.
Twinkle, twinkle think, think, twinkle think, think, twinkle think. Think.
Beets!
Oh, and beans!
And booger berries!
Maybe not booger berries.
Okay! How about broccoli?
Oh, yum, yum!
Beautiful! Bee vegetables coming up! Snack time, Bunny Fufu.
Oh, yum, yum.
He's eating.
All right, fairies, you know what to do.
You're a goon, you're a goon, you're a goon.
Oh, it worked.
Yeah. guy. If he can't bop, what's he gonna do now?
I always wanted to do ballet.
Great B-word, Fufu. Come on, class. Let's boogie.
Today, class, for show and tell, Molly Sue Zlotnick has something very special to show you.
This is my pet iguana, Tolstoy. I got him when he was a lot smaller. I fed him every day. He got bigger and bigger and bigger. When I get home from school, I take Tolstoy for a walk on a leash. I clean Tolstoy's house and make sure he has fresh water to drink. He likes to stay up late and look at the moon and the stars. And sit under an umbrella when it rains. At first, sometimes, people are afraid of Tolstoy. But after they get to know him, they're not afraid anymore.
Are you ready for an adventure? Great! Because Bert and Ernie's great adventures are coming soon. But first, we're gonna check out...
the number three!
How many is three?
One, two, three! Three jumps! Three babies! Let's count soccer juggles! One, two, three!
Can you count to three?
One, two, three!
I really love the number three! Come on! Let's check out more about the number three!
Three animals come into view. A cow is first, just hear her moo. A moose is second, and who's third? You're right if you said it's a bird. The animals leave, but then, look out, here they come again. And now in first place, it's the bird. The cow is second, and the moose is third. That's right, first, second, and third. But the moose puts on a sudden burst. Look, he's moved from third to first. The cow is falling back to third, and now in second, it's the third. Well, you've learned all about first, second, and third, and you did it with the help of the cow, moose, and bird. Let's ask them all to take a bow. The moose first, the bird second, and third, the cow.
I see pictures dancing in my head.
Picture sleep.
Buddy Bert.
What?
Buckle up and we'll fly away.
Whoa! Yeah!
We're adventuring. Every time the bed starts napping, something special's gonna happen.
This is kinda catchy.
My favorite kind of traveling.
Yeah!
We're adventuring. Come along with Bert and Ernie. We're gonna take a little journey.
We're in beautiful Scotland by the beautiful lake Loch Ness.
We're in beautiful skirts. What are we doing in skirts, Ernie?
It's called a kilt, Bert, old laddie. Lots of guys wear them here.
And some lasses, too. Would you boys care to hire a wee rowing boat?
We sure would. And maybe we'll get some postcards.
Gee, this one looks interesting. It's some kind of monster cartoon.
Oh, that's the famous Loch Ness Monster. Some folks say she lives in the loch. We call her Nessie.
I think she's kind of cute.
I don't know, Ernie.
Don't worry yourselves. I don't think you'll be seeing her. Our Nessie is just a myth.
A what?
A legend. A made-up story. Right enough. If anyone ever got a photograph of her,
They'd be famous.
Famous? We'll take two disposable cameras, please.
Ernie, she's a myth.
Now, would you like to borrow my bagpipes? Playing them will make you feel truly Scottish.
Wow, thank you.
Off you go, lads. Have fun.
How about you row the boat for a while, Ernie? I am pooped. Wow, look at these beautiful hills.
You know, it's funny, Bert. I'm pretty sure that old Loch Ness monster's around here somewhere. I can almost feel it.
For the last time, Ernie, she's a myth. She doesn't really exist.
Hey, take a picture of me in my kilt.
Ah!
Gee, I don't sound that bad, do I?
Ernie, it's Ness! Nessie!
Where?
There! There she is!
Row us closer, Bert. We've got to take her picture.
All right. But she sure looks big for something that doesn't exist.
Faster, Bert. Hey, I've got an idea. You can row while I blow. Wow, I think she's having fun with us, Bert.
You call this fun?
Aha! We've got you cornered, Nessie.
So you do. I knew I should have stayed underwater today.
Aw, well, don't worry, Nessie. All we want is one picture.
Aye, and all I want is to be left alone. I really like being a myth. I'm shy.
Then why'd you pop up to see us?
I couldn't help it. I love to hear the bagpipes.
I understand how you feel. You know, Ernie, Nessie doesn't want us to take her picture, so maybe we shouldn't.
You're right, Bert. Hey, wait. How about you take our picture, Nessie? Just so we can remember this special day when we met you.
I'll be glad to. Say, Nessie.
Nessie!
Right now, let me give you a tug. It's true what they say. I am fast.
Whoa!
All right, lads. I'm off. Back down where I belong. Cherry bye.
Thanks, Nessie.
Cherry bye.
Welcome back, boys. Did you get a picture of our Nessie?
No, not today.
But it was a pretty unforgettable adventure. Oh, and thanks for the bagpipes. What a great picture Nessie took, huh, Bert?
Yeah. Hey, but what's that funny shape down in the corner?
Oh, my gosh. It's Nessie's finger. Good night, Bert.
Good night, Ernie.
It's almost time for Elmo, but right now, we're gonna play What's Missing? I'm all ready to go skateboarding. Or am I? Take a close look and find out what's missing. See it? Check it out. Yes! I'm missing a wheel! Great job! Now keep watching, because Elmo's on the way. I'm gonna go get a new wheel.
You know I'm a girl who's gonna change the world.
She's gonna change the world, she's gonna make the world a better world.
When I grow up, oh, what can I be? Well, take a look and see. I'm gonna be the best me that I can be. You know I'm gonna change the world.
You know she's a girl who's gonna change the world. She's gonna change the world, she's gonna make the world a better world.
Can I be a doctor? Oh, absolutely. I can be an MD and help the sick become healthy.
You know she's a girl who's gonna change the world. She's gonna change the world, she's gonna make the world a better world.
Can I be a judge? Well, my answer is sure. Yes, I'm happy to report I can be a judge that serves the
court. You know
court.
She's a girl who's gonna change the world. She's gonna change the world, she's gonna make the world a better world.
Can I be an astronaut who travels so far? Yes, I reach for the stars. I'm gonna be the first person on.
You know she's a girl who's gonna change the world. She's gonna change the world, she's gonna make the world a better world.
Nothing's gonna stop me. Nothing's gonna get in my way. I'm gonna make a difference. Gonna start today. Can I be the president?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Did you guess yet?
You know, bird. Oh boy.
That's right, birthdays.
Mr. Noodle?
Oh, yeah! You need paper!
Use the paper to wrap the present.
Not that much paper,
that's
Mr. Noodle.
That's
stop,
that's
Mr. Noodle.
That's enough. That's enough paper.
It's too much!
That's enough. That's enough, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle!
It's
too much!
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
Not too much this time, Mr. Noodle. Be careful.
You need scissors to cut the paper, Mr. Noodle.
Oh, yeah. You need scissors, Mr. Noodle.
Yeah, use the scissors.
Very good, Mr. Noodle. Okay, now cut the paper.
You cut the paper good, Mr. Noodle. Nice looking.
Now, wrap the present.
Wrap the present.
Wrap the present, Mr. Noodle.
Yeah, wrap the present. Oh, no.
You need tape.
Yeah, that's the tape. Yeah, very good. Now, pull off some tape, Mr. Noodle. There you go. Oh, no.
Not that much tape. Just a little bit, Mr. Noodle.
It's going to get stuck together.
Too much tape, Mr. Noodle. It's sticky to you. Try again, Mr. Noodle.
Keep going, Mr. Noodle.
Wrap the present, Mr. Noodle.
Wrap the present first. And now the other side. Very good.
Wow.
Mr. Noodle, remember, just a little bit of tape.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
He's doing it.
You got it.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
All right, now, finish wrapping the present.
Finish it, Mr. Noodle.
Keep going, Mr. Noodle.
Yeah, there's more.
You have to wrap the ends of the present.
Both ends?
Just a small piece of tape, Mr. Noodle.
Just a little. That's enough, Mr. Noodle.
Yay! You did it, Mr. Noodle!
You wrapped the present! Yay!
You wrapped your finger, Mr. Noodle.
Take it off. I wonder what the present was.
Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you wrap a birthday present?
Hi, Dorothy. This is our wrapper birthday gift. Put in a special bag. Happy birthday, Dorothy. Dorothy, this is how I wrap a present. I put a big bow on it. You have to take the paper off the sticky part, then you stick it on. Happy birthday, Dorothy.
This is how I wrap a present, Dorothy. I fold the paper onto the box like this. Then I fold the corners. And I do the same thing on the other side. Now I put a bow on. There. Happy birthday, Dorothy.
Thanks, kids. Oh, thanks, Dorothy. And now Elmo will ask a baby. Hello, baby. Hi. Hi. Oh, baby, how do you wrap a gift? Thank you, baby. And now Elmo has a question for you. How many candles are on this birthday cake? Let's count them and see. Here they go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Seven! Yeah, seven birthday candles. Oh, how many elephants does it take to blow the candles out? Oh, there he is. Oh. Oh, silly elephant. One. Thank you, elephant. Great counting and great candle blowing. Boy, it must be the elephant's birthday, too. Oh, that makes Elmo wonder. What can have birthdays and what can't? Elmo wants to know, don't you? Okay. Oh, boy, it sounds like the drawing knows. Open up, drawer. Do birthday cakes have birthdays?
No.
Well, you can eat birthday cake at a birthday party. Do telephones have birthdays?
No.
Well, you can call to wish someone a happy birthday. Do ponies have birthdays?
Yes.
But ponies don't eat birthday cake. They can have a birthday apple. Happy birthday, pony. Do trash cans have birthdays?
No.
But Oscar has a birthday in his trash can.
Don't remind me.
And fish have birthdays, too. Oh, is Dorothy having a good birthday? Oh, good. And ponies have birthdays, and grouches...
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Be
Elmo
careful, has... the beauty.
Elmo has...
Oh, no.
Elmo has mail.
The computer crashed.
Elmo has...
Elmo has mail. Bring it in, fellows! Ready, everybody?
Ready!
Happy birthday, Dorothy!
Bye-bye, Elmo!
Bye, Dorothy! Email me, Dorothy!
Thanks, computer! Oh, be careful! Dorothy left her email. Now, where was Elmo? Oh, that's right. Everybody has birthdays, even mommies. Elmo's friend Hampton made a special cake for his mommy's birthday. Oh, his daddy helped too. And Hampton told Elmo all about it.
My dad and I made a cake for my mom for her birthday.
We
We found my mom's favorite kind of cake in her cookbook. Then we followed her directions. I helped my dad break the eggs. We have to be careful so that eggshells don't get in the batter. Add milk and vanilla. Then mix those together. You mix flour and sugar and salt and baking powder in a bowl. Then we mix the wet and dry ingredients together. My dad used the electric mixer. I got to taste the batter. We poured the mix into a cake pan. Then my dad put the cake pan in the oven. When the cake was done, then we put on the ice cream. I decorated the cake myself. And gave it to Mom. I helped her blow out the candles. Then we ate the cake. Yummy.
Oh, Happy gave Elmo a piece of his mommy's birthday cake. Great cake, Hampton. But now, Elmo wants to learn more about birthdays, don't you? How can we learn more? Oh, yeah! Elmo can watch the birthday channel! Good. Okay, turn yourself on, TV.
The Birthday Channel, where every day is a birthday. And now, the girl who loved birthdays.
Once upon a time, there was a girl who loved birthdays.
I love birthdays.
She loved birthdays so much, she traveled all over the world to celebrate her friends' birthdays. She went to Iceland, where they had special pancakes with syrup for her friend Bjorn's birthday.
Yum!
I love birthdays!
She went to Mexico, where they had a piñata for her friend Carmen's birthday. A piñata is filled with goodies.
Oh, boy! A ball, candy, and a peso! I love birthdays!
She went to Israel, where they played a game called Bli Yadayim for her friend Avi's birthday.
Try to get your hat on your head without using your hands.
Okay. I love birthdays!
And when she got home to Ypsilanti, it was her birthday!
Happy birthday!
Oh, yeah, I forgot. It's my birthday. I love birthdays.
Coming up on the Birthday Channel, Born Free, Born on the 4th of July, and Born Yesterday.
Oh, thank you, TV.
Wow. There's so many special things to do on birthdays. But Elmo wants to know more about birthdays, don't you? How can we find out more?
Want to talk to a birthday cake?
Whoa, yeah, we can talk to a birthday cake. Yay! Oh, is it fun being a birthday cake?
Yeah, it's a piece of cake. Ho, 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 ho.
Tell Elmo more about birthdays, cake.
Well, for starters, birthdays are to celebrate the day you were born.
Oh, look! Dorothy is imagining Elmo being born.
Oh, boy! George is almost a daddy.
Oh, boy. Gladys is almost a mommy.
It's a boy.
He is so cute. What are you going to name him?
Elmo.
And after that, you celebrate your birthday once a year. Some people like to have parties.
Happy birthday, Elmo!
When you get older, you can play games at your birthday parties. My favorite is pin the tail on the donkey.
Hey, I've already got a tail. See there?
Sorry,
Donkey. You already have a tail.
Yeah.
And you always sing happy birthday to celebrate the day you were born.
Yeah, that's fine. So let's sing happy birthday to Dorothy. Be right back.
Okay. Good idea. I love singing happy birthday. Mm-hmm.
Ta-da!
Oh, nice hat.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Here we go. Oh, you can sing along, too. Get ready, birthday cake. This is for you, Dorothy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Dorothy. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, now Dorothy wants to sing the birthday song. Come on, everybody.
Birthday, 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 birthday. Birthday, 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 birthday.
Oh, light the candles, Dorothy. Yeah, come on, dance, cake.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter, I can't remember today's letter. Let's rethink the day. Here's the letter! What letter is it?
T!
Right!
T is the letter of the day!
But what's today's number? Ooh, there it is! What's the number?
3!
Yes! 3 is the number of the day! So Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter
T
and by the number 3. This is Murray saying see you next time on the street. Peace.